And Dr. Michael White of the UConn School of Pharmacy would know. He was part of a larger group that just finished a comprehensive review of all the known major studies on hydroxychloroquine. He said the interest in the drug was understandable, especially given the urgency of the situation.
One of the things that was really attractive about it was that it was relatively inexpensive, and manufacturers were already making it, so the chance that they would be able to gear up and have adequate supply of the drug over a relatively short period of time was high.
But that advantage only works if the drug works. Dr. White said many small studies were done on patients who were very sick with COVID-19, and to say they were inconclusive was an understatement.
If you focus on the controlled studies, the ones that some people got hydroxychloroquine and then other people that were in a similar hospital in a similar circumstance did not get hydroxychloroquine, what you see is that the studies are all over the place. Some studies are showing benefit, some studies are showing harm, and then some studies, and actually most of the studies for the endpoints that they're looking at, show very little benefits one way or the other. And then on top of that, the methods that they're using are really, really bad.
He said, on top of being poorly constructed, those were studies on single cells, which have limited value.
Those things don't always pan out when you look at human studies, though. And so it gives you an initial lead, something to start with.
Dr. White said there are currently no studies as to whether it can prevent COVID-19, which is why the president said he was taking it. But what about the risks? Dr. White said the possibility of cardiac arrhythmias and other problems is there, especially at higher doses, but many people are exaggerating those probabilities as well. I'm Tim Lammers, Fox 61 News.